Hey ladies and gents, it's Sam, and we are doing a review on the LaGG 3 Series 4. In the tech tree, this is the premium Tier 4 Russian multi-role fighter. And honestly, this has kind of become one of my favorite planes to play. I mean, it's not, you know, maneuverability is not great, ultimate performance is not great, airspeed's not great, survivability, blah, blah, gun armament, once again, not the best. But it's an impressive little airplane. I mean, it's a lot of fun to play. So the history behind this plane is that this was one of the first modern aircraft developed by the Russian Air Force. This replaced, the I-16 series. This was the, like I said, one of the first modern aircraft produced by them. The interesting thing about this aircraft was is it was actually a large chunk of its airframe was made out of wood, laminated wood, which was extremely strong. It didn't catch on fire, and it could last for years in adverse weather. So it was kind of an interesting, you know, change from most modern fighters at the time that were using aluminum and whatnot. The problem with the aircraft is that it was a very heavy, aircraft for the engine that powered it, and in that sense, it was very slow. They built something a little over 6,000 of these aircraft, and it eventually was replaced by the Yak. But for the most part, it did not have a stellar career in the Russian Air Force. Which isn't surprising, I guess. If you have an underpowered aircraft, you know, it's of course never going to be able to perform. By 1941, they knew it was underperforming compared to the BF-109 series. So it just, yeah, it was just a never, it was just there. And they could build it so quickly. I mean, they could build 12 of these aircraft a day with this wooden airframe and whatnot. So yeah, it was very easily constructed, built in large numbers and that kind of stuff. In fact, by 1941, when they talk about, so we get the LaGG 3, right, Series 4, there were 66 series of these aircraft. And by February of 1941, there was already 2,200 modifications requested for this aircraft. So over the next batch of 66, 66 batches of these aircraft, all these modifications were added to this aircraft in an attempt to make it better than what it was. In fact, it didn't actually get solved until they added the radial engine, and the LaGG 3, of course, became the what essentially was the LA-5. This engine solved the problem of being of the LaGG being so underpowered. You can see, of course, the airframes and the wings are very close to each other. You know, that's all they did. Chopped off the inline engine, slapped in a radial engine, and they produced a much better aircraft. So what do we have in game? Well, this is a multi-role fighter. It carries one hub-mounted 20mm and a 50mm plus two 7.62 synchronized machine guns that fire through the propeller, and the outboard weapons, of course, are two rockets, eight rockets, RS-82 rockets. This has, you know, as a dogfighter, you know, it's not the best, doesn't have the best turn rate, doesn't have the best firepower at this tier, but it's pretty damn nice. In fact, I think my highest combat score is in this plane. But it does carry enough rockets that you can take out a medium-sized ground target with that, which it makes it kind of, you know, an important thing when you're dealing with, say, a command center where you only have two fighters, knock out, you take it out, you still have to knock, you know, turn the objective, you still have to knock out a ground target. So this is why these things are relatively nice, because like I said, once you take out the planes, you can drop down, unload your rockets, and flip a objective pretty quickly with it. For the price, what is it going for? It is going for, I don't even remember. I think a little over, was it 3,000? Tier 4. Let's see what a Tier 4 costs. Yeah, I would say I think it was 3,000 gold, maybe something like that. Somebody will know off the top of their head. For some reason, I can't. I'm not sure what it is. Where is that at? The cost of this. Well, anyway, it costs you some gold, right? Okay, but so like I said, two thumbs up on this plane. This is a great little plane to play. With the multi-fold roll features, it is so nice, so capable, so versatile. You can get into the dogfight, you can get out of the dogfight. It's not the best at everything, but it's pretty balanced all the way through on its performance parameters. The rockets, of course, help take out the ground targets, and they also work wonders on heavy fighters that want to go head to head. And it's a relatively tough little airplane. I mean, you can take a ram from most fighters at Tier 4, and you can usually shrug it off fairly easily. I don't know if that's to do with the wood construction or whatnot, but hey, that's what it is. Excuse me. I usually run a lightweight airframe, control surface adjustments, and of course, improved reflector sight. Just because, in 64 is not bad. You can get it up just a little bit more. If you can get that optimum airspeed down, here with the maneuverability, here's the optimum airspeed is 190. If you can get that down around there, it does turn fairly quickly. This is no Yak One of, or not Yak One, I was sorry. The I-16s turn a little better and all that stuff. But I think it's what's really nice. Like I said, you can just get enough with those aerodynamic upgrades. You can just get enough that you can slow the plane down and use flaps that you can stay on a target long enough to kill it. With the three machine guns and the 120 millimeter, and that to me makes a big hu makes a huge difference. Of course, you can if you wanted to, you can always spec this out somewhat different. Just about anything will absolutely will help you. Of course, the aircraft polish, engine tuning, depends, like I said, what you're going to do with it. If you want to do a little bit more of a multi-role GA role, you can of course outfit it otherwise. That's the great thing about multi-roles, it depends on what you're going to use it for. You can do that. Like I said, altitude performance is not bad, maneuverability is not bad, airspeed is not bad, the gun armament is not bad. It's just they're all kind of meh, but for some reason it works in this package, and you can do a pretty nice job with it. So I'm going to bring up the gameplay for you guys, and you guys can check the plane out for yourself. All right, guys, back with the first game in the LaGG 3-4. Or LaGG Series 4, I guess you want to call it. And we are off in the off to the races here. I love spotting next to these objectives that shoot the shit out of your plane before you can even get out of range. I have the mining facility here, and of course I'm heading toward the garrison. I'm was at about this time I realized, you know what, something's not right here. I have no planes with me. They had all headed toward the center air base, and hey, this was not going to work out. So I flip up and over. I'm just going to wait here just a little bit. Wait till the bots get in here before I enter. Of course, I'd like for them to get the shit shot out of them before I do. But of course, the AA doesn't want to cooperate, so this is what we're going to do. Drop down low here. I'm going to salvo my rockets in here and pick up a ground target, or part of the ground target, before I start engaging my enemy planes. So I got the AO-192 coming around on him and get right in on him. And you can see, like I said, that with this gun armament, it does a really nice job. Surprising with three machine guns in that 20, how quickly it does. So I actually only have one tent left, and I pick up that ground target and come back down on the HE-51. Yeah, there you are, buddy. We'll get you. Turn in on him. He's flying away. I only need one more plane to kill, and of course, I'll have the objective. So I pick up actually all three of those and return the objective essentially by myself. And that's one of the nice things about this plane, with that ability to do that. If you have to take a ground target, you have enough rockets to take out a ground target. And of course, you can always dogfight with most of the defense fighters. So back to center, we got the blob of red currently coming in here. So pick up the AR. Yeah, we're gonna finish you off. They flip the cap right off the bat. We're just gonna have start knocking out planes. see how it goes. We are heavily outnumbered here. Yeah, stall that, stall it, stall it. You'd think after this many years, I would just figure out how not to stall a plane. Flip back over, and there you are. Hawk 75M is coming around. Gives me his nice, nice silhouette, and start pummeling him. Yeah, there we go. Almost dead. Finally knock him out. Start to even up the odds here a little bit. Their defense fighters are up. And of course, I have Irwin coming in here on me. And we'll go head-to-head. No problem. That firepower is so nice on this aircraft. It's surprising how, with just 120, how big a difference that makes. And it's a 20 that doesn't heat up real quick. So you can put a pummeling on a lot of planes here. Pick up the Hurricane 1 off the bat. Leaves me with the I-16. Yeah, there we go. Yep. Finish him off. I'm already sitting on a nice 6,700 combat score here pretty quickly. So pick up the Hawk 75M coming in. Flip over. And finish him off. And you're going to see what I'm talking about when I, you know, I use the aerodynamic equipment on this plane. And this is kind of what, you know, and I'll show you here what I'm talking about. It just gives you just enough turn rate to a lot of times stick with some of these planes in a turn that can, outturn you. You're able to stick around long enough to stay on their tail to finish them off. This, of course, was worked out really nice for me. We, you know, we had the mining facility, and of course, we got the center right off the bat. So it was relatively easy just to sit camp base. Now, surprisingly, you know, this being what it is, once again, center objective maps, you can rack up these ridiculously stupid high scores. And, you know, I'm not going to say that that's broken, but yeah, it might be just a little bit broken here. Pick up the Hawk 75M again, and we drop down, see if we can pick up him as he rolls away. There you go. Pick up my grade 3 and a Lambert's medal. Got an incoming. Whoa, there you go, doggy. He's not even paying attention. He's so bit worried about his ground attack. That's all right. I don't mind shooting a Hurricane in the ass on his way down. So he does a up and over roll. Pick him up, flip over myself, and of course I got an I-16 coming in here. And we have a steady stream of the red players coming back this way. They don't seem terribly interested in going after that, the rocket base over there. So hey, that's all right with me. I can just sit here all day and pick up easy kills left and right. So stall out again, back down we come. And I'm looking for another target here. And surprisingly, they had actually knocked down a few planes while I was busy doing my thing outside of the cap. This Hawk 75M had shot down a fair amount, had shot down something or did some damage somewhere, because we only had it sitting about half on the objective. That's all right. We'll get that broadside again, buddy, and we'll pick him up right again. Put me up at 12,000. And now I'm going to go start looking for something else here. We are sitting pretty nice, 247, two objective points, and now they've kind of given up on coming back to center. My bots have moved off to other objectives, so now I'm starting to look for something else to shoot at. So I got Hawk 50, or Falk Wolf 57 up, Hawk 75N up, and they all, like I said, the altitude's not bad on this plane, it's just not the best. Of course, I stall out trying to get up there, and I flip right. Flip back around and knock 75M. I get set on fire by something. Not sure what it is. And he's not going to get away this time. Flip over. Still have another Hawk 75M. I don't know where all the Hawks are coming from. Can't quite get around on him. There we go. Now we're on him. You know, and that 20mm has some nice range on it. See if I can follow him across the map here and see if I can get another kill on this guy before the squall line comes up. Like I said, at this point, 318 to 222, it was looking pretty nice. The bots have moved off, and we're doing a nice job of picking up objective points. So pulling on the Hawk 75M, yeah, let's just finish you off, buddy. There we go. So pull around, and I'm going to head over here to where I see the red blob of airplanes and see what we can do. This plane, you know, for the most part, it kind of follows along with the actual... realistic plane, it's the real plane. It is not terribly fast. altitude performance, once again, is not the best. It is adequate. The firepower, in my opinion, is really nice on this plane. This thing can just rip through planes left and right. Like you said, right, see right there, once you get all these, you know, the four machine guns and the 20 on target, they run through planes relatively easy. Pick up the Hawk 75M. He's the human pilot. Let's see if I can get him finished off. And you can see, like I said, just lets me stay on just enough to finish him off here. So we've got the next Hawk 75M coming in. He's not looking good. Yep. Thank you for giving me your side. Yeah. Pull up and away. So they only got four planes left. It's not looking good for the baddies, but that's all right. A5M's down. And we have one bomber and a ground attack plane, and I believe one fighter left. Yeah, and we're going to head over here and see if we can pick up this Hawk 75M. He had just respawned right now, and he was coming in here. So he was looking for some bots to shoot. He himself, being a bot, doesn't really care. So, pull in here on Irwin. We got the minor sector. We are sitting pretty right now. There's, this is going to end poorly for them. So pull it back around on him. See if we can get him finished off. And we pick him up. So, got one bomber up top. And we are done. Nice 19,525 combat score. I didn't get the little star on the top of my badge in the center, so what are you gonna do? So yeah, it's a two thumbs up plane. You know, it's not the best turner, it's not the best firepower, it's not the best, but it's adequate in just about everything. And if you can get into positions and work with that, you can do a lot of damage and make a lot of coin. I do believe this one was a 100 and. I think this was 150k game or something like that. So pretty decent moneymaker at tier 4. So I got one more game for you guys to check out, and I'll bring that up right about now. All right, back with the second game in the LaGG 3. I made a mistake on the last game. That was a 200,000 silver game with that 19,000, almost 20,000 combat score. This one was about this one was 130,000 silver, not quite as good as the last game, but yeah, like I said, I made a mistake on that one. I didn't look it up right off the bat. So move off to the missile base right off the bat, of course, with the two AO-192s. I'm gonna stay up here high and see if I can pick off these guys. Like I said, I also carry a set of rockets, so I do have the ability, if need be, to finish off a ground target. You know, that's, like I said, one of the greatest things, versatility of this airplane. Carrying that extra ordnance lets you pick up some ground targets. So, flip the military base, and now I'm off to see if I can pick up the garrison. Slow. And like I said, this has to do with the more of the fact that is, I think it's historically correct, because it is just an utter dog if you have to fly any sort of distance. So this is what really makes this is important is, of course, is controlling airfields. So you don't have to fly around too much with this aircraft, because it just, like I said, takes forever. So pick up the first set of aerial targets coming here. I got a Bristol. And HE-51, and of course Curtis, they have this cap relatively close. They had apparently dropped or had lost one of the planes, so this was going to be a relatively easy one to knock out. Pick up the kill on that plane, flip around here, and of course I got an HE-51 coming in behind me. But luckily, we flipped the objective. So already up three objectives right off the bat. And this was actually looking to look like a, you know, utter trounce. And there was actually no point in even worrying about it, because I thought, this is going to be like probably a 6,000 combat score. And that's all I was going to get out of it. Pick up the AR-80. And, yeah, we're going to pummel him to machine gun oblivion. So, pull back over. Got the Ki-27 come in, which could be an issue. Ki's are relatively, maneuverable aircraft, so I really don't want to get in a turn fight with them. However, I don't have a problem pick up on a Focke-Wulf 57. That pretty nice little, burst into him. That's one of the actual nice things about the planes. It does have a significant burst damage with that 50, the two 7.62s, and of course that 20. You keep the 20 somewhat cooled down, unlike what I'm doing right now. You have a pretty good chance of ripping through a plane relatively easy. Can't quite pull off the up and over. I said this is relatively underpowered, at least engine-wise. But hey, you can't have the best of all worlds with these aircraft. Finish him off, and I got incoming fighters again. And I kind of got myself strung out here. I was looking like it was going to be pretty decent coming in here, but there, I got a little too close to their spawn point, and things get a little dicey here. I got a Focke-Wulf coming in. I got planes here. I got red planes. There's red planes everywhere. BF-109E is going to get in a turn fight with me. B, I'm sorry, wants to get in a turn fight with me. I'm just going to try to keep. There we go. He turned away. He thought he was going to go the other way. My pilot's damaged, so my reticle is fucking huge. Finally, get it down. He finally decides that, you know what? I think I'm just going to put it on the deck and run. Problem is, you can't run away from a 20. It just doesn't work that way. So he's running, he's running, he's twisting, he's doing everything he can. And of course, he turns the wrong way, gives me a broadside. And I am right at the spawn. I guess you could call me a spawn camper. But apparently, the Focke-Wulf 57 finally had enough of that shit, and comes, puts me out of my misery. So, sitting about 8,700 combat points, and I'm gonna have to respawn. Probably, yeah, of course, with no air first base, I'm gonna have to respawn there. And then, of course, I'm gonna head right directly toward the objective that is closest to me, which worked out pretty damn nice for me. We got the rockets incoming. So this is gonna look, it's gonna be relatively easy for me. HE-51, he wants, she wants, they want to go head to head. Oh, my precious, there you go. Knock it out. Flip the objective. We got two right now, and we're sitting pretty decent. This isn't even really gonna be much of an issue here. I'm heading over to the other objective that's getting close to being turned. Relatively soon, the rockets are actually gonna start falling on it. So it's not gonna be too hard to flip this objective. Come up, and you've noticed, like I said, already the yellow is our, I mean, we're already in the yellow at 2,700 feet. So, not the best altitude performance, just good enough to do what you got to do with it. The Skua, however, is getting his shit shoved in. He was able to flip the objective, and I'm coming in here pretty hard, just maybe just a little too hard because I have another LaGG 3 coming at me, and of course another human pilot coming with me. And get a ram from the other LaGG, come back around. Yeah, we're gonna go, ooh, head to head. He gets a little quicker on me, and nails me, puts me out of the game for a little while. However, he lost his life as well. So we're gonna fast forward a little bit here, and back I come. Squall lines up in five, perfect timing. We're already up 492 to 285. It's looking pretty nice. I got four rockets. This objective, of course, is very nice that it actually turned next to me. It's already half taken, so I'm gonna come up in here. Now, however, the AO-9192 is falling away from me, so I don't really have much of a chance to actually catch him. Excuse me, I'm suffering from a cold, so I'm just gonna drop down here on the ground. I got rockets loaded. Pick up a quick ground target, and we're gonna see if we can do it. We can do it. Come on, 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 come on. Nope, can't do it. Yeah. Actually, I did hit that and did kill him. Surprise, surprise. Oh, lovely, lovely. Gotta love that RNG. So, you guys said you can get a little bit of a feel for this aircraft. with the ability to, for the most part, dogfight if you got to. It's got, the guns are good enough to take on heavy targets, good enough to take out ground attack planes. It had carries just enough ordnance to take out soft targets. You're talking about the 30, 40 point ones. You should have no problem with that with the eight rockets and that machine gun and cannon setup. You can usually take out a soft target pretty easily with a salvo of rockets, or even actually take out two. A couple of those places that have some tents set up, you can launch four rockets in there, take that out, and you can launch another four rockets in another one and take that out. So it does a pretty nice job as a multi-role, having the ability to take out the ground targets. And of course, if you've seen the videos, it does a pretty nice damn job at playing the fighter role. So, hope you guys enjoyed the video. And if you get a chance and got a little cash laying around, go pick up the plane. So, we'll see you guys.